Hello everyone, I'm Krassi. I will be talking about the lunar eclipse, which will take place on 30th of November. I will share my screen with you to show you the very interesting chart of the eclipse. This is just not an ordinary chart. It is a very interesting horoscope of this eclipse. I will analyze the eclipse as usual using the ominous texts from ancient Babylon. Before we look at this eclipse, let me tell you that the energies of this eclipse are a combination of the energies of the previous eclipses of this year. You know that in 2020 we had already four, one to come in November, and one last one sixth on the 14th of December, which will be total solar eclipse. We have solar eclipse in total in 2020. This is extraordinary high number of eclipses, which only adds to the difficult nature of the year 2020. Next year, I think we have just a few eclipses. But this year, we are really heroes to go through six eclipses and many other celestial configurations. However, this eclipse, I don't see as that bad. It is very interesting. It is a turning point, and I will tell you a bit more about it. Like I said, I'll be looking at the ancient ominous texts, which from where I'm receiving information to compare with the current eclipses. So before I share my eclipse with you, to show you how the sky will look at the moment of the eclipse, I'm using the fixed sidereal Babylonian zodiac, which is sidereal astronomical. So you, when I show you the image of the horoscope of the eclipse, you will see exactly, literally, what is happening on the sky. So this is the sidereal picture. Just to give you a brief overview. Before starting, you know that the eclipses, when they take place, the energies may, the results of the eclipse may happen 3 to 10 months to a year after the eclipse, even longer. Therefore, it is difficult to say that it is a mixture of energies. We are still going through the influences of the previous eclipses, which took place this year in the summer. However, I'll explain you how this eclipse will influence us according to my perspective. Now, first of all, what is important? This eclipse is taking place on the 14th lunar day of the Babylonian month called Kislev. Now, the 14th lunar day always points towards the ancient city of Elam, which is contemporary Iran. It is related in a way to China too, which would say that we will hear about these countries as they will receive influences from this eclipse. I will tell you more what, but these countries will definitely experience powerfully the energies of the eclipse. This will be contemporary Iran and China. Then the eclipse is happening in the month of Kislev, and the month of Kislev is affecting Subar too, and this city is corresponding to contemporary Russia. Russia will also heavily be influenced by this eclipse. Then this eclipse is happening in the morning watch. You know, those who follow my channel, probably you remember I've been explaining how the ancients would divide the days and the nights into parts, which they would call watches. And depending on when, during which watch the eclipse would take place, they would denote certain qualities to this eclipse. So it is taking place during the day morning watch. And it has some benevolent influences. They say, I will even read you, when the eclipse is taking place during this particular watch, sick people will become well in Akkad. From our perspective, Akkad would relate to contemporary Europe, but will have also certain impact on Iraq. So, sick people will become well. I found this in many translations from cuneiform tablets of Babylon. So this is just an overview. I will tell you more. I'm sharing my screen with you in a very little second. All right. Now you're looking at the horoscope of the eclipse. Extremely interesting. Very, very interesting. Look, this here is the axis of the eclipse. The moon is in the 14 degrees of Taurus. The sun is in the 14 degree of Scorpio. This is the most potent, the most powerful axis in the zodiac as we know it. Because in this axis here, and in these particular degrees, we have two royal stars, which with the other two, which will be here in Leo and in Aquarius, are forming the cross on the sky. This is a sacred cross. It is a very, very important, potent configuration, the cross. Now, the moon is conjoined the star Aldebaran. The sun is conjoined the star Antares. Aldebaran is the star in the eyes, in the eye of the celestial bull. This star is enormously related to money and power, money, power, luck. This star here has the nature of Mars and Venus. Many, many powerful people, really mighty people in our contemporary history would have this star on a key position in their horoscopes. And then we have the sun conjoined the star Antares, which is in the belly, the stomach of the celestial scorpion. This is the axis of money and power, the most powerful axis of the zodiac. What is happening? Of course, money and power will be affected. That, now, let's see further. We have also, this is happening. Now, just to explain, also these two positions here are representing two of the archangels, which are four, or the four animals. Now you have two archangels, which in a way are participating. I'm sure that Aldebaran is ruled by archangels Michael. I am not sure the other three archangels, which of the three positions are ruling. If you have ideas, I will be happy to hear that, because there are too many speculations, too many versions of which are the three other archangels. We know which are they, but I mean, which positions in particular they rule. Which archangels rule Regulus from Leo, which one Scorpio, and which one Aquarius. There are too many versions, too many stories, too many speculations, so it's hard to decide. But I'm sure that Aldebaran is ruled by Archangel Michael, who in a way is participating in a very karmic way. Now, another interesting thing, of course, is, yes, we said this is the axis of money, very, very powerful. But there are other interesting things. At the very moment of the eclipse, which is happening in the morning, which is related to healing, because we said that when eclipse is happening in this particular watch, the sick will recover. But what else? The dispositor of Taurus, the ruler of Taurus, Venus, is in super powerful position, and she's on mid heaven. And even if you look at the chart from the position of America, Venus also remains in a key position. So this is a European chart here, but the American chart was also very, very similar. I think 1 hour was the difference. So you would see here Venus in Libra on mid heaven, and according to the ancients, when benefic star is participating in eclipse, is visible and also actively participating, like Venus in Libra in her own sign on mid heaven, she's reversing the bed. Another thing, in the moment of the eclipse, Mercury participates in the eclipse because he's in Scorpio, in the third degree of Scorpio, in another sacred degree, hermetic degree associated with knowledge. We have Mercury, who the day after will become invisible. So it is the last day of visibility of Mercury. He's trying to tell us something. He will reveal information. A lot will come out after this eclipse. I see this eclipse more as benevolent than bad. I know that most of the eclipses are considered to be dramatic events. They are. But this eclipse happening in the morning watch with Venus on mid-heaven, I don't think to be that bad. Another thing I will tell you, even the malefic planet Mars is creating sextile. Jupiter and Saturn in the moment of the eclipse are about to form their conjunction, and they're trining the moon and sextiling the eclipse. So this would say that this eclipse will be a turning point historically. The results from this eclipse will be that the information, like the information will continue coming out, but this time without being so much restricted. It will be a turning point, because suddenly here comes Jupiter, who is who with Saturn are trining and sextiling the positions of the eclipse, and in a way they will participate in this turning point. They will bring historical change related to finances, to truth that will come out. Why am I saying finances? Because this axis is the axis of money, very, very much. Venus is on mid-heaven. Jupiter and Saturn together in a way will bring structure, and they will support the process of, it will be maybe a turning point, but I do think that now this will bring positive development, like justice. The events will start coming into place. We know that the elections were stolen in America. And actually, very interestingly, this particular axis here is a lunar eclipse. And it happens to be that Donald Trump is born on a similar eclipse, but reversed. So it will be turning point for him as well. So we'll see him in a different shade, in a different light. Just after the eclipse, things will start turning probably in his benefit, because this is a repetition. He's born during lunar eclipse, and we're having again lunar eclipse, and Rahu and Ketu are in the same position as in his natal chart. This is a turning point also on the chart of America, because we know that the ascendant of America is Scorpio, Sagittarius Scorpio too. So this is a turning eclipse, which will be really turning point, but not towards bad and evil. I see this as something interesting, as truth which will come out, some justice will be introduced. The archangels are really participating to give us some hope. Venus is watching from mid-heaven here, and she's ruling the moon in the eclipse. So this is a very potent, very powerful eclipse. Now you will say, okay, but the next eclipse is happening just 14 days after, and it is happening on the 14th of December. Indeed, and it is another interesting eclipse, again associated to finances, and again related to disease, and it is happening again in relation to money star. And in addition, I'm looking now even at this eclipse. And in addition, the coming eclipse also has Venus to participate. So these two eclipses, to the next eclipse, I will give separate additional attention. But this eclipse now, the other one as well, but this eclipse is a very interesting turning point. It's like after this eclipse, things will start coming together into place. Slowly, slowly, some justice will be revealed to us, the real information and truth will start coming out, because look at this Mercury. He's still in the secrecy, in the secretive house of Scorpio, of course, but he's visible, and just after the eclipse, he's disappearing. So he will show us something that will be turning, like play the role of a turning point, and then he will disappear. And then And it will be from the depth, from this, it will be, we will be seeing information, and it is a turning point. We do have already the direct Mars, which is so very important. And here is the B sextile, Jupiter, Saturn sextile, Mars, Mars sextile, the Moon. Actually, the aspects are not devastating in relation to the eclipse. And we do have the blessing of Venus, which is ruling the Moon in the lunar eclipse, and Venus is in a very powerful position. It's like watching after us. So I do think that this will be a very potential, a powerful turning point, which will most probably be positive, or will start, at least it will be a small start for better and more positive and wide development in our best interest. Now, let's not forget that this is just a small element from a chain of celestial events. Let's not forget that we had Saturn-Mars conjunction, that we had many complex celestial configuration that will remain on the sky, so we can't expect suddenly that things will get easy. I don't think that they will suddenly get easy, but we will see hope. And I do think that that this is a very important help from the sky that we're receiving through this eclipse. I always see my opinion always very, very was that the eclipses are dramatic events. They are. In very few Babylonian texts, they would say that this eclipse will be good for a king or not. But very few texts would read the eclipses as positive. So it is possible to have eclipses that will be turning points towards something that will work out in a positive direction. So this is my opinion about this eclipse. However, let's see on personal level what is going on. Keep in mind that what I am speaking is really very global. It is on mundane level, which concerns each one of us. But if you do have Taurus ascendant, sidereal or tropical, this would be, of course, Gemini. If you have a moon in Taurus, or if you have Taurus ascendant, or you have sun in Taurus, or if you have Taurus on your midheaven, keep in mind that this eclipse is something heavy. It is still heavy. And if you're planning to do important events or to travel, wait until the next moon at least. Wait for some time, because depends on your natal chart, depends on how now Saturn is transiting on your natal chart, exactly which aspects he's making according to your natal chart. It depends on your personal chart to see how the eclipse is working on you. But still, during eclipses, especially if you have Taurus on a key position, Scorpio on a key position in your horoscope, sidereal or tropical, Gemini, Sagittarius, then you may need really to be cautious. You may need to postpone some important negotiations, travels, new beginnings, surgeries. You may need to do that, because these are powerful celestial events, and it could be that this eclipse locks your luck for a while, delays your business, your activity. So you may need to wait. Again, it would depend on your horoscope, but still, eclipses are eclipses. On a mundane level, this eclipse can bring justice, can be a turning point, which we probably need right now more than anything else. But on personal level, this is probably not exactly what you may need. Therefore, be a little bit cautious. This is an eclipse. Again, don't watch the eclipses. I do not advise. I wouldn't watch the eclipse. It is a morning eclipse, and it probably won't be easy to see, thanks God, but still it is happening. I think it is a very long eclipse. It takes place, it starts in Europe from, I think it was 8 in the morning, and continues very long, 3-4 hours In the States, the difference was only 1 hour, I believe. So it is an eclipse that will be that will be very long. Another way of eclipse interpretation is that the duration of the eclipse can be calculated into years. So this would say that if we say that this eclipse would take approximately 3 hours and a half, which I read would be 3 hours and a half, the influences of this eclipse will be on us will be 3 years and a half. So this we may expect that the energies of this eclipse, this turning point, this change economically, and also the justice, the truth that this eclipse may bring, will have influence on us for another 3.5 years. According to the watch, like I told you, we divide the day and the night into watches. The eclipse will influence us for 10 months approximately. So you can see, in any case, it will take long to experience these the influences of these energies. So, well, yes, this is globally. Let's see in what way this will be a turning point. You know, it is important because it affects both the horoscope of the current president of the States, Donald Trump, and it affects also the horoscope of America, as it is happening directly on the ascendant and descendant of America. And the whole world is dependent on the events that are taking place in America. So it will be a turning point, and the current situation now will turn into something else, and it will have to do a lot with the horoscope of Trump. It is eclipsing the ascendant of the other candidate for president, but not in benevolent way, if the time of birth is correct, which I'm not very certain about. We will see after the elections if this is so. So this was my analysis of the coming eclipse. I will analyze the next eclipse, which is happening which is total solar, very important eclipse, which is happening on the 14th of December. Hope to hear from you, also your interpretation on the archangels, how you think that they're represented in the zodiac, because we know that they do rule the four animals, the four royal stars, but there are so many versions that it's hard to see which one is ruling which. So thank you. Looking forward to your comments. Bye-bye.